Now, you most likely keep an eye on sugar contents and other unhealthy ingredients that you need to eat in moderation, but how many of you watch out for genetically modified foods? Most probably not many of you. For most, this won't be an issue, but if you live in the US, there's a good chance that at least some of your food has been genetically modified. Stay tuned to number one to find out which item you thought would be completely natural is actually genetically modified. Number 10. Canola. Developed through conventional plant breeding, canola was developed by breeding rapeseed, which has been in use for millennia and was even used as fuel by many ancient civilizations. The first genetically modified version was originally bred by University of Manitoba, Canada, by Keith Downey and Baldur R. Stefansson during the 1970s. That strain was called Roundup Ready canola, developed to have a tolerance to glyphosate. This was done by introducing two genes. The first, called Agrobacterium, which is a common soil bacterium with a gene from the Agrobacterium antroi strain LBAA, which honestly won't mean much to most of us. Surprisingly, a whopping 90% of US canola crop is genetically modified. Number 9. Potatoes. Nearly all of us will be familiar with the hardy potato that has been a staple part of our diets for thousands of years. But did you know that some strains have been genetically modified? The potato was first domesticated in modern-day southern Peru between 8,000 and 5,000 BCE. It was first introduced to Europe following the Spanish conquest of the Incan Empire, and since then it has been introduced to all corners of the world. An estimated 382 tons of potatoes were produced in 2014, with the People's Republic of China producing the most at 95.5 million tons. In recent years, genetic researchers have produced several genetically modified varieties of potatoes. The new leaf potato was genetically modified to resist attacks from the Colorado potato beetle, but was unsuccessful in making a dent in the market, so sales were discontinued in 2001. In more recent years, the USDA approved a modified potato, the innate potato, which contains genetic modifications that reduced or prevented bruising. Although these have gone into circulation, the Food and Water Watch petitioned McDonald's, a major consumer of potatoes, to not use this new strain of potato. Thankfully, McDonald's agreed. So if you eat McDonald's fries, at least you don't need to worry about consuming this particular genetically modified food. Number 8. Eggplant. Eggplant, also known as aubergine, has been cultivated in southern and eastern Asia since prehistory. Strangely, the plant has also played a role in Italian and Egyptian folklore. In the 13th century Italy and 19th century Egypt, the plant was liked to cause or have increased levels of insanity among the populace. The genetically modified version of the eggplant is also known as Bt brinjal. It was created by inserting the crystal protein gene taken from the bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis to make it resistant to pests. It works by enabling the plant to produce a toxin that kills the worms that devastate crops. This strain of the eggplant is only cultivated in Bangladesh, but as it is only a recent phenomenon, it's too early to judge its success. Number 7. Papaya. Papaya is native to Mexico and northern South America, but has since been introduced to Florida, California, Hawaii, and other tropical and subtropical regions like India. It turns out that only the female plants are used for cultivation, though, as the male plants provide poor quality fruit. In 2014, India produced 44% of the world's total, estimated at 12.7 million tons, which is a lot of papaya. But it hasn't been an easy ride for the plant. Papaya production was hit with a deadly virus that nearly wiped out the entire world crop. The virus, known as the papaya ring spot, first hit the crop in Hawaii in the 1940s and within 50 years had spread to nearly every area that grew the crop. Regardless of whether you agree with genetically modified food industry or not, if it wasn't for the Hawaiian-born scientist Dennis Gonzalez, we wouldn't be able to feast on this delicious fruit today. His creation, known as the rainbow papaya, was designed to be resistant to the virus and has ensured a stable and sustainable income for the people of Hawaii, as well as the other places it's grown. It is clear that genetically modified papayas have helped to ensure its continued availability today. So maybe not all genetically modified foods are bad. Number 6. Soybeans. Humans have been cultivating soybeans for thousands of years. The earliest evidence for domesticated soy was found in China and dates back to between 7000 and 6600 BCE. But other parts of East Asia, such as Japan and Korea, also domesticated it as far back as 5000 BCE and 1000 BCE respectively. Introduced from China to North America in 1765 by the East India Company, today, the U.S. grows 32% of the world's total soybean production. So why is it classed as a genetically modified food? Well, as with many other crops, scientists and businesses are always seeking for ways to improve crops and increase profits. Soybeans were originally genetically modified using the genetic engineering techniques because manufacturers wanted to attempt to grow soy at a minimal cost and to fix problems in the growing process. However, since then, they have found that they can modify the crop to contain healthier components. The first genetically modified soybeans were introduced into the U.S. market in 1994, and since then, a total of 93% of all soy is believed to be genetically modified. Number 5. Sugar beet. Grown commercially for sugar production, the roots of the sugar beet plant contain a high level of sucrose. The modern version of sugar beets date back to around the mid-18th century, which is fairly recent in comparison to some other examples on this list. The King of Prussia, Silesia, was known to subsidize experiments aimed at extracting the sugar from the plant. By 1840, only around 5% of the world's sugar production came from sugar beets. But it soon spread around the world, and the first attempted cultivation of the crop in the U.S. occurred in 1836. However, it was unsuccessful. After further unsuccessful attempts, it wasn't until 1870 that the first successful sugar beet factory was being built in the United States. The U.S. was also the first country to genetically modify sugar beets, of course, by engineering them to be resistant to glyphosate. Several studies have found that glyphosate-resistant sugar beets contain the same nutritional value as conventional sugar beets. And in 2011, about 95% of sugar beet crops were planted with the resistant strain of the seed. Number 4. Squash. You might be surprised to learn that there are two genetically modified varieties of squash available in the U.S. markets. Squash has been present in the Americas long before the arrival of humans. Surprisingly, the earliest known evidence for domesticated varieties of squash date back nearly 8,000 years ago. A variety of cucurbita, which is the family that squash is found in, was a major food source for the native people of the Americas long before the first European contact, and it remained an important food source in the following centuries. It was even featured during the first Thanksgiving. The two varieties of squash that have been genetically modified are the green zucchini and the yellow summer squash, and both have been available in the U.S. since the 1990s. They have been genetically modified to be resistant to several viruses like the cucumber mosaic virus, the yellow mosaic virus, and others. But don't worry, the chances you're eating genetically modified squash is relatively small, as only 25,000 acres of the virus-resistant GMO varieties are grown in the U.S. today. Yet, that does mean someone's eating it. Number 3. Apples. Most of us would have eaten or at least seen an apple during our lifetime. They have been cultivated for millennia and have even played a crucial mythological role in various cultures such as ancient Greece, European Christianity, and Norse traditions. Today, it has grown worldwide. And in 2014, the total production of apples was 84.6 million tons, with China making up the most of that. In recent years, cultivators have utilized biotechnology to genetically modify apples. Arctic apples is the name given to a group of apples that have been genetically modified to contain non-browning traits. It was one of the first foods to receive a trait solely intended on pleasing customers, because nobody likes eating a brown apple. many American and Canadian citizens distrust genetically modified foods, and the cultivators of the Arctic apple have been quick to highlight that the apple has undergone gene slicing biotechnology instead of having genes from different plants or animals added to it. With the first sales being made sometime earlier this year, we'll have to wait to see how successful it's been. Number 2. Honey. You'll likely be surprised to find honey on this list at all, as it's a pretty natural ingredient. Bees have been making honey for approximately 200 million years, and it's highly probable that humans ate wild honey before they evolved into anatomically modern humans like you or I. Modern humans have been exploiting honeybees for nearly 9,000 years and later domesticated them, giving them an endless supply of honey and wax. So how on earth is it a genetically modified food? Well, bees collect nectar from numerous flowering plants, but they don't know which ones are organic and which ones have been genetically modified. As a result, when a bee takes nectar from a genetically modified crop, it unknowingly transfers it to their honey. So how can you guarantee your honey is GMO-free? Well, it's a hard thing to find if you live in America. An estimated 95% of corn and soy in the US is believed to be GMO. And because bees roam far and wide around bee farms, it's difficult to ensure the honey they produce doesn't contain genetic modifications. If you don't want to get honey from bees that have been kept in large cages or containers, you'll have to shop around to get honey from other countries where it can be guaranteed the bees haven't been feasting on GMO foods. Number 1. Salmon. It's not just plants that have been genetically modified, and in 2015, the US FDA approved genetically modified Aqua Advantage salmon for commercial production. Humans have been studying the life history of salmon since the 14th century, but it wasn't until the 18th century that fertilization tests took place in Germany. And later, in the 20th century, the first salmon farms were established in Norway and Scotland. Since then, scientists and fish farmers have been trying to increase production. In recent years, a company, Aqua Bounty Farms, produced a genetically modified salmon that grows almost twice as fast as conventional salmon. Not only do they grow quicker, but they are also more resistant to the disease and the cold, and they even require 10% less feed during their lifetime. Now that is a clear business success. In 2015, the FDA approved this fish for commercial consumption, and it has since been sold to Canadian customers. With increasing demands on natural fish populations and concerns about declining wild fish communities, perhaps genetically modified fish is the way forward. What's your opinion of genetically modified foods? Would you eat them? Tell us what you think about the genetically modified foods we talked about in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more interesting stuff.